Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to update data in PostgreSQL database by using Node.js as well as Postman. So let's get started. So I have already written the code for connection, and if you want to watch that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top, because in this video I'll be showing only the update operation. So if that's fine, let's get started. So let me just begin by explaining you the code. So we'll be using two libraries, one is PG and Express, and this is my connection variable. We are passing all the necessary parameters, and this is the connection I'm making it over here. And at the last, we are having our app.listen to start our server. And in the PostgreSQL database side, I'm just having a table named as demo table, and these are the values that are present inside it. So now let's see the update operation. So for update, we'll be requiring the ID, because only with the help of the ID in our table, we will be able to update the other values. So that's what I will be doing. So let me just go here. It's going to be app.put. Okay, that's the thing that we'll be using for update. And inside this, we will specify the path. It's going to be /update/:ID. So I'll be getting the ID from the URL and the other parameters from the request.body. So it will be something like this. Imagine this is the URL. I will be passing the ID from here, and the other values will be coming from here. So that's how I'm going to do it. And next is going to be request, response. So now we need to get the ID value from this, okay? So for that, it's going to be const ID equal to request.params.id, okay? So this variable and this variable should match. And next we need to get the request.body values also. So in my case, I'm just having name alone. That's the other column that's going to get updated. So it's going to be const name equal to request.body.name. That's it. Next we'll be writing our update query, which is going to be a simple SQL update query. Let me have it as const update query equal to, within double quotes, it's going to be update space your table name. So in my case, the table name is demo table. So I will just put it over here. Set the column that we want to update. So in my case, the only column that I want to update is name. So I will just put here name equal to $1. And we'll be using the where clause, where ID equal to $2. So this ID, this is the column name that will be coming over here, the other column name that you have. So in case if you have some register number or some other column name, that column name should come over here. Okay. So these are your column names, name and ID, not these values that I get from here. So now we are done with our update query. And next is going to be, we'll be executing this update query. So for that, come to the next line. It's going to be your connection variable. This is my connection variable in my code. So it's going to be con.query. And inside this, we'll be passing few parameters. First one is our update query, comma. Within square bracket, we will be passing the name and ID. It's going to be name, comma, ID. So you need to be careful over here when passing the values. The value that you pass first corresponds to $1, and the value that you pass second corresponds to $2. So don't interchange ID at first and name second. Name should be coming to $1, ID should be coming to $2. So be careful with the order there. And next is going to be a callback function. It's going to be error, comma, result. And we'll be just having a simple if condition. If there is any error, we will just send response as error. And in the else block, we can just send updated, or you can even send the result. That's totally up to you. I will just send updated. So that's basically the query, guys. Only this much. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me save it, and if I run it now, it's going to be node your file name.js. Yeah, everything is fine. Now let me go to Postman, create a new one, and me just remove this. First thing is, it's going to be put. Make sure that you're changing to put over here because it will be get by default. So just change this to put. And next change is going to be, you need to have this HTTP colon localhost and your port number that you have specified over here. In my case, I have 3000. And you need to just copy this path and put it over here. So the ID, so in my case, I'm just having this ID 200. I will go with that. It's going to be 200 over here. And next is the body, click on body and you need to go to raw JSON, select JSON from this list. Within curly bracket, I'll just put here name and I will just pass a name over here, just a random name now. And this name should match with this value, okay? This value, this name that we are getting over here. So now if I send it, our value for 200 should change over here. So this should be QWERTY over there. So I will just send it now. Yeah, I'm getting updated. So this is this one that's coming as a response. And if I go and run the query, select table query, here you can see the value has been updated. So this does the job. And imagine in case you are having another column. So let's say you are having another column as address. So in that case, what you will be doing is you will just have the exact same thing. You will just put here, just have it as address. Here also you need to change it to address and make sure that you are having address over in the table also. Okay, you should have address there. And here also you will like put a comma and pass here the address like this. Yeah. And next in the query, you will just put a comma and you will just have address equal to $2 and this will be $3. The ID will be $3 and here in the center it will be address. This value should come over here. So this is in case if you have multiple columns. So in case if you have another one, it will be $3 and ID will be $4 and here you will be adding that value. So just do the correction if you have multiple columns. So that's the video, guys. I hope you'd have found this useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming, CRUD operations, in Spring Boot, Node.js, MongoDB, MySQL, as well as OpenAI, Gemini AI, API, and other AI tools. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.